You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to BorisFX.com for the premium download.
Welcome to the second shot. In this section, I will go over project file setup tips, shot approach, shape creation, layer organization, additional roto features, and more options for tracking. I've loaded in our sequence, visible down here in the Sources window, and we're going to work right next to our completed project file. Our sequence is longer than our assigned task range, but I created my session to the full length. If I click to the thumbnail and list view here, you can see that our footage goes from frame 0 to 184, but that our shot work is actually going to be 70 to 140. And why did I do that? If the client changes the frame range and adds extra frames at the head or tail, then your session will already be properly set up to continue. This means that the start frame in the session dialog box will be the first frame of the sequence. So if we go to session settings, you can see here that even though our session started at 0, I manually made the range from 70 to 140. I'll close this. And how I did that is I just typed in whatever number needs to be the first frame for our roto. And then I also locked it so that I can't scrub and change the range. So if I unlock this, and you can see if you accidentally scrub through here, you can change the range and that could be problematic. So I'll just go back and change that to 70 and click the lock button. I also make a habit of adding a note and listing the frame range that is needed to be worked on, and I also list what needs to be done. To add a note, you can go to the utility section, click on the note, and drag it in. And now you can see we have a little area here where we can add some notes. I'm going to go down to the node properties, click A, and that will let me start typing in the box. And I'm going to put in our range. Frame 70, 0, 140. And it's a little small. I can make it a little bit bigger. Just highlight that and I'll make that 18 so I can see it really well. You can even change the color. I'm selected over the numbers here. Click the color here. I'll just choose green. And now you can see it's a nice bright green. Hit return. And now I can just put down the list of what needs to be done. I find that this little bit of extra organization helps me, and if my project file gets passed along, it will also be helpful to others. If I want to change the color of this text, I can just select it here in the note, click on the color, select white, click OK. I'm going to change this back to green. And maybe I'll make this text a little bit smaller to 14. And there we go. It's easy to read and we can start. I'm in the streamlined workspace, but I can drag the sashes, these dividing lines between panels, to customize my workspace. When you see the split line cursor, you can drag the sash. You can also experiment with different configurations. If I click on the roto node here, you can see my panel is below, but I can click this button here, this icon, and we can float the panel. I can nest it in a different section. Once we get it close to this dividing line here, it can go right in between. And then I can have my roto object list in between the viewer and the trees window. And if I like this configuration, I can save it as a workspace. We'll go up to workspace, save workspace, and we'll call this KD Roto 2 and click OK. And by accident, if you close a panel by clicking the X button up here by accident, you can always bring it back and go up to window in the object list and it'll bring it back. I'm going to float it back in below my trees window. Sometimes it needs a little bit of help here. And actually, if that's not going to work, you can just go up to workspace and click streamlined. And now we're back into the streamlined workspace. Now it's time to talk about what my shot approach was, and I will play the shot through. But first, I'm going to make an ROI to help conserve memory. I'm going to click on the ROI icon up here, and I'm going to make my boundaries a little bit smaller. And I'll just scrub through a little bit to make sure I didn't cut off the middle of the cyclist and the bicycle. I'm just going to focus on the middle area for this class. Pull that in. Okay, once I'm happy with my new boundary, I'm just going to click this icon again. And now I have my smaller image and we'll cache the shot through. And over here on the left, you can see you have some options for playback. You have loop, bounce, or once. And I keep mine set to loop. I'm going to zoom in a little bit, and another way to zoom in besides plus and minus is to hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button, and then you can zoom in on a smaller incremental basis as opposed to the plus and minus. And you can also do that with your Wacom pen if you have the middle mouse programmed to a button on your pen. So here we have both a moving camera and moving objects. And for this shot, I needed to roto the cyclist and the bike as if we were going to add some elements in the distant background. So this footage will provide some opportunities for manual roto and roto with tracking assist. And in the end, I came up with this layer structure here, and I'll just expand this so we can see. I'm going to select my layers and we'll hold down shift. It expands all of them. And this is the organized layer structure that I came up with many layers nested inside top layers. But we'll get started in a brand new roto node. I'm just going to pull that back down, and I'm going to add another roto node off to the side. I'm going to go to the nodes tab here, silhouette, and I'm going to drag in a roto node here. I'm just going to reorganize my tree a little bit. I'm going to hook this up off to the side so we can easily go back and forth. If I want to add a little dot here to move this away, just hold down the Alt key, and then I'll just drag this off to the side. And I'm going to disable the main roto node first so we don't accidentally mess something up in here when we're working in the demo. But what I'm going to do here is that you can actually name nodes. I'm going to call this roto. I'm going to call this final. The roto node has a new name, but I'm going to disable that so that we don't, by accident, mess something up. And now we have our roto demo here, and I'll just make this roto demo. I took a bit of time to assess the footage. The ask is straightforward, but there are many moving body parts. They're all connected, but all moving a bit separately from each other. And then there are the strategic decisions of whether to do manual roto or rely on tracking help.